What's up with Vinny's? There we go.
Yeah, it was.
Okay. That was weird. Yeah, what is that?
Should I not be clicking on that?
Yeah, you can turn that off now, bro.
All right.
Well. Yeah, that's what we're looking at, everybody. We don't want to see that, though.
No.
Vinny looks like, he looked like the Emperor. Look at him. Can you shoot bolts of lightning out of your hands? The folks at STARDOM Japan.
Oh.
They specifically asked if Granny would review the pay-per-view from this past weekend.
Wow.
And I was so excited to get this link to her so that she could review STARDOM for the Bryan and Vinny show, and then she couldn't get it to work. I will try to show you how to make it work, which is by pushing the play button, okay?
I tried that, but it wouldn't come up.
Well, you got to push it and wait a little while.
Can you share that link with just anybody?
No, I can't. Are you kidding me? I am a professional, Craig. Paid my hard-earned money to watch this thing.
Okay, I'll watch my inbox. Thanks, buddy.
Granny, you committing a crime right now?
Yeah, well, I better not come to your house.
I've been watching Murr, she wrote.
Taking notes?
Yes, I used to have an 8-speed. Bryan had a tricycle, and we'd go out on the walkway or whatever, and he'd get tired and didn't want to do it anymore, so I had to get off and push his tricycle.
I have a history of laziness.
Mm.
One guy was talking about somebody pulling a gun, and so I'm
during bowling? Was it the Big Lebowski?
Was it Walter?
Yeah. Was his name Walter? That's right.
Yeah, Walter.
Say it.
S-A-B-C-H-A-C-K.
Yes.
I looked it up, and I'm not kidding you, I never heard such foul language.
My mom won a world championship match in bowling?
Yeah, well, I mean, national probably just.
So not world.
Well, that's not world. Are you sure it wasn't just the local alley?
No.
The world championship of bothell?
No, it was a U.S. championship.
This better end up on my Wikipedia. Oh, wow, look at this. Someone told me to check out my personal life on Wikipedia. And it says, Alvarez's mother is a United States champion in bowling.
Oh.
There you go.
How about that? WWF Smackdown, September 4th, 2001. As we dip our toes back into stinking, rancid water that is this invasion.
Oh, this show was not bad.
It wasn't?
If you keep telling me these shows are bad, I'm going to make you watch Raw and Smackdown in 2021.
Don't do it, Vinny.
And then you can get back to me.
Are there not any more any biographies we can go back and watch?
Wow.
Perhaps the life and times of Duke Trocy.
This is that bad? This is a segment that you would not see in 2021.
What?
Holy smokes, this segment.
The Rock.
I can't believe this. They went through and they're editing Peacock and that is still on there? I don't think we're going to do the ratings anymore. I guess we could. Does anyone care?
The whole purpose of the podcast.
Why do you have no audio?
The more important things than ratings is getting people to hear me. Talk. I am talking now. Do you hear me at all? There's nothing going on the screen over there. Hello? That better?
Somehow your gain got turned all the way down.
I hate when that happens.
Who's in here twiddling with my knob?
Bryan.
I hate that. If you're going to Chicago for the AEW All Out show, Dave and I are going to be doing a Q&A.
I can't announce I'll be in Chicago.
Yes.
And I'll be at All Out.
I may have you there as our own Brandon Cutler. I may have you show up and just film and spray him with some of that spray. I got a buddy there who he's always texting me. Did Mr. Khan's check clear after that show you did ranting about NXT last night? I was like, dude, listen. Who is the babyface in this segment? And they texted back, Gargano's the babyface. And like, I couldn't type fast enough. I couldn't type the word bullshit fast enough. Johnny Gargano is the most unlikable little fly. And Karrion Kross is this big man with a fly swatter, and I want to see him swat this little geek.
We now have a field of competitors.
Yeah.
For the breakout tournament.
A bunch of big dudes.
You know what else we got here, Bryan? Intangibles!
Your biggest fan says, Vinny's Intangibles.
This should be good.
Vinny's Intangibles is that his is intelligent, inspirational, and great will. Bryan's intangibles are, he is a whining, comma, anger, comma, and his genetically jackhammer.
Not everyone's a gifted essayist, gifted linguist. We all have our strengths. We're not all wordsmiths out there. He finally hits the Panama Sunrise, follows with the last shot, and he gets his big win. So, in a vacuum, as a match, awesome. excellent main event.
How long can I talk about a good match? What the hell is there to say? Like, Adam Cole and Kyle O'Reilly, they had a great match.
Yeah.
What are you expecting? Of course they had a great match. What can I say about it? You want me to just rattle off all the moves they did? Like, there's only so much I can say about these three good matches. But their weakness is the storytelling, the character development. And unfortunately, that's the kind of stuff that I could talk about for hours. So it is true that a show that I really liked, when you listen to me review it, it can sound like I didn't like the show, but I did. But there are many, many problems with the show, and I wish that those problems would be remedied.
Jericho and MJF have their face-off. There's a fan invasion.
Jiminy Christmas. Don't do this, people.
This is...
God damn, first show back, and some dude hits the ring in the middle of Chris Jericho's entrance.
The NBA has had all sorts of problems with this. People throwing things at players and stuff. And
what's going on?
I don't know. Unless everyone just went crazy being pinned up for a year.
When I watched it, I looked at Jericho's face. And it was actually a great face for the segment because he just looked fucking irritated.
Yes.
He looked really pissed off and irritated for this whole segment. But it actually made the segment even better because he was so irritated and then he got so fired up at the end.
Yes.
Tony Schiavone is just a person. So he listens and he looks like a guy who's paying attention. And when she said that Saudi Arabia line, but he just turns and he sternly looks at the camera like, I can't believe she just said that. It was so great, his reaction to that line. Seidel is a high flyer. He's a tremendous athlete. He moves quickly. He can do all sorts of crazy stuff. That's the Andrade that I was expecting in this match. I didn't get it. I got a slow, ground the guy, basic, by the numbers wrestling match with a couple of high spots by Andrade. But the guy who looked great in this match was Matt Seidel.
Mm. The lights go out. When they come back on, Aleister Black is in the ring. Yeah.
And so I think one of the reasons that he got such a huge pop was because I think a lot of fans figured, A, that because Zelina had gone back to WWE, that he...
A lot of people thought he was...
...was going to go back to WWE. And I think they also figured that if he didn't go back to WWE, he still couldn't debut until his 90 days were up. Little did they know he had an out clause, somehow, in his 90-day no-compete.
He cut the best promo on this show. He cut one of the best promos you'll hear all year, anywhere.
He's every boomer.
Yes.
Who thinks all this shit was better back in the old days.
Yes.
These fuckers here, they just do flips and shit, and they can't work. He was unbelievable.
The last 5 minutes of this match had like a month's worth of spots and angles, but it's crazy insanity. If you like crazy insanity, it was a hell of a match.
Dude, I thought this match was awesome. Loved it. The running Canadian Destroyer off the apron through the table, Penta and Mac Jackson, that was just absolutely nuts. Of course, it is time to vote, and I'm going to vote for a tie. The better show, it's AEW. But I am a pro wrestling fan, and NXT had three very good pro wrestling matches.
I agree.
So in all fairness, I will give this a tie.
I liked both shows. NXT had the best stuff. It also had the worst stuff. It was more up and down, but I liked both shows, and so I'm also going to vote for a tie.
How about that, everybody? Yeah. A tie game here tonight.